There's just something about playing a PlayStation exclusive on the Xbox Series X that makes this all the more satisfying. Hey everyone, and welcome to the Cloud Gaming Extreme channel. Microsoft Edge support for GeForce NOW has now dropped. This means that the Xbox Series X Edge browser, if you have the latest update, is now able to play GeForce NOW. And yes, you're seeing Kena being played on the Xbox Series X via the Edge browser. Now there is a few caveats here. You may notice that you're not getting full 4K. This is capped at 1080 on GeForce NOW, and there is no upscaling in place other than the fact that it's stretched in your browser. It's also worth noting that if you have to sign into Epic to play something like Kena, it is an absolute nightmare. There is no keyboard support from the browser in Edge, so even if you get the mouse to work by pressing and holding the right menu button, it doesn't give you the pop-up for the keyboard. To get around this, you either need to do what I did and plug in a physical keyboard, or go to a computer or your phone, launch the game, sign in via Epic, and then just quit the app, and then pick up the session on your Series X. Not the most elegant solution by any means, and as it's capped at 1080, having it on a 4K screen may not be the best solution. Gameplay wise, actually it plays extremely well. You can tell it's upscaled, but on the TV it's nowhere near as noticeable as on a PC monitor. So it is playable and it does look and feel very good. Using the Series X controller, there was no input latency and it really played quite well. I just don't know whether it's worth playing at 1080 with it pushed up at this time. However, try it out if you want and see what you think of the kind of native upscaling, I'd call it, of your TV. It may make it good enough. If you're looking at this on a phone screen, it's going to look very good, especially once those vibrant colours come back in once the rot's gone away. And I will say that on the TV screen it did look very good, but once you got up close you could tell that it was upscaled, so this will be very interesting if we get the 3080 tier to see if it makes much difference in the browser. Now we also thought we'd try New World, as playing New World on the Xbox Series X also seemed like quite a cool idea. However, it was much more of a pain, even though Steam was auto-remembered, to get it working very well. If you plug a mouse and keyboard in, yes, the mouse and keyboard works, but as you can see, mouse support in the browser kind of goes a bit weird and gives you this touch control. And also, for some reason, the game started up in 720, and I actually really had to fight with the menu to get that up to 1920 by 1080. Once that was done, the quality still is very obvious that it's only 1080p and stretched. It didn't look the best at all. New World only has partial controller support, so you do need to use that mouse and keyboard. But as you can see here, the mouse was absolutely useless. So I ended up using a combination of the controller and keyboard. Again, not the most elegant solution, so I have to use the Q, R and F keys on the keyboard, and E and tab for menus and stuff, but the controller did manage to use light and heavy attacks. At least it did with the Warhammer. For the light staff or anything using charge attacks, it was extremely unreliable to whether it actually did anything. So it really is not a great way to play New World on the Series X right now. Hopefully they will add controller support in the near future, and we'll give this another try then. So if you are going to play any games on your Series X in the Edge browser, I would recommend that it's only ones with controller support. Anything else really makes life difficult, and as you can see, New World looks okay. It really doesn't look that good even on the TV, but not having that controller support really makes it pretty much unplayable. So let us know in the comments below what game you're going to try on your Xbox Series X, if you have one. This should also work on the Series S, in which case the upscaling shouldn't look as bad. Thanks for watching, don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things cloud gaming, and we will see you next time.